The inside lining of the uterus is called the endometrium. An endometrial biopsy is the removal of a sample of tissue from the endometrium for testing. The procedure for sampling endometrial tissue has been simplified by the use of a sterile, disposable, flexible suction device, such as the Wallach Endocell, and does not require anesthesia or hospitalization. Endocell's most important features and benefits include moldability for easy insertion, elastomeric seal O-ring for excellent suction, and numbered sounding marks for safety and precision. An endometrial biopsy may be done for the following purposes: to screen for cancer or precancerous conditions, to determine the cause of abnormal bleeding, to test for fertility problems, to test for uterine infections, and to monitor the response to certain medications. An endometrial biopsy is usually done in women over age 35. It is not intended to be performed on pregnant women. The procedure requires the patient to lie on the examining table in a position similar to that used to obtain a pap smear. First, a manual exam will be performed to determine the position of the uterus. Then, a speculum is placed in the vagina to open it up and keep it open so the cervix is visible during the procedure. An instrument called a tenaculum may be used if the uterus is not close to axial in position. The tenaculum is used to grasp the cervix and keep it steady during the procedure. An endocell, which is a long, thin, flexible suction tube-like device, is passed through the vagina and the cervix and gently into the uterus. The average uterine length is 6 to 8 centimeters. The piston plunger must remain fully forward in the sheath during placement. Once in position, the piston plunger is drawn back to create suction. It should be rotated and moved up and down in the uterus so it can suction an adequate sample of endometrial tissue. When the catheter is visibly filled with tissue, it can be removed. The endocell should be removed, keeping the plunger withdrawn. If there appears to be insufficient tissue for diagnosis, a second pass may be performed with the same endocell, as long as it has not come into contact with anything. The contents of the endocell should be placed into a container filled with formalin, which is a mixture of formaldehyde, 40% by volume, methanol, 10%, and water. At that point, the procedure is completed, and the tenaculum and speculum may be removed. Pressure should be applied to control any bleeding. The doctor will send the sample to the lab for testing, where a pathologist examines the sample under a microscope to determine whether there are any cell abnormalities and follow up with the results for the patient.
When it comes to customer service and product reliability, Wallach works for you. To learn more about the Wallach family of products, please visit our website at www.wallachsurgical.com.